So here we are in the Ignition Designer looking at the business connector. And I hope you get a sense of what we're looking at here. This is a what we call a business connector chart. You can see that it involves several steps. Let's start with a very simple one here. This one's called Output Materials. And it involves a start step, a step where I'm communicating with an SAP BAPI, and an end step. Let's follow these a bit more closely. In this start block, I'm able to configure chart parameters that allow me to keep track of data that I find and recover and receive along the way. It also allows me to set values ahead of time when I call this chart. Then that's followed by the SAP BAPI block. The SAP functionality here enables you to really navigate hierarchically or alphabetically through the various BAPIs or business APIs that SAP provides for us, from attendance to equipment to, you know, functional locations. In this particular chart, I'm looking at the BAPI called Material Get List. And what I'm trying to do is retrieve a list of materials that I can then throw up on a screen on the Ignition side. So I'm able to communicate via sequential RFCs, transactional ones, queue-based. We support all of these sorts of idioms that SAP specifies. Now, I want to walk you through this particular block here. As you can see, there's an input tab and an output tab down here. On the input tab, the get materials endpoint here requires some endpoint from me as the user. In this case, it wants from me my maximum number of rows. And so as you can see, I have mapped in a max rows value. So when I call this chart, I can say, give me 20 materials. And let's show you how that looks over in Ignition. On the other side, we get an output table called material number list. And this is kind of in this raw SAP output, material description. And we're going to transform that again into this nice format that I've pre-configured with just name and description. And then that comes out of this chart for use in an Ignition screen. So if I head down to my screen here, I'm able to call this chart and fetch all those materials from SAP. And I'm able to scroll through those and see all of those material names, which are these great leading zero material names, and these descriptions. And then I'm able to select these in turn, and it will go query SAP again for more data about these. How does that work? Well, if I head back up to my charts, there's another one called Get Details. And that takes in a material name and gets more detail about it. So if I look at this here, you see how I'm able to map in all of that data from that, again, that raw ERP output into this format that I want. I'm able to exclude the things I don't want. I'm not interested in the container, the storage conditions, the temperature conditions. I just want my name, description, type, division, and group. So I map those in a very drag and drop functionality, and that powers this screen. I'm able to quickly get a list of data and hop between them and understand really what I have over on the SAP side. So I know that my Ignition installation, my SCADA system, and my ERP system are all in sync. I'd like to show you a more involved use case. Like I said before, Cepasoft, we make the MES modules as well. And so a common use case is wanting to retrieve materials, operations, schedules, work orders from your ERP system. So I have a pair of charts that retrieve materials and save them into what are called MES objects. The first one is called Get MES Materials. And it looks not dissimilar from that first chart in that it has a start block, an end block, and a get materials step. But you see we have a new block called Save MES Objects. So let's walk through these here. Again, we start with a start block with a max rows parameter. And in this get materials block, again, I am just retrieving that material number list table. And I am mapping that over into what's called B2MML. That's the format that Joe described a moment ago. And I am getting a material ID, a description, and a material class. And as you can see, I'm not actually getting a class from SAP, so I'm actually providing one myself. We have this nifty way to modify and create functions. In this case, I'm simply setting that class to be materials. In addition, if I go on to there's one more step here. So now that I have mapped this data, I can go on to this save step, where I save the output from the previous step. So what does this give me? Well, it enables me to save my MES materials. So let's go down to a screen where I can show this in action. If I head to what's called my MES object editor, you can see that I currently have no materials. If I click my Get Materials button, it will call that chart and retrieve those materials. And I provide a row count of 20, and so I only retrieve 20 of those materials. And they're all sorted into that materials class. And if I look at the settings, you can see I got the name and I got the description. Now, I have one that says Get Classes. So if I hit that, I'm also going to retrieve the SAP group name. So you can see how not only do I have the materials, but I also have the classes. So if SAP gave me a SAP group for that material, I'm able to sort the materials into those classes. How does that work? If I head back up to my chart, this one's called Get Materials from Class. And in this chart, I'm again getting that list of materials, but instead of just simply mapping out and saving right away, I am iterating over those materials one by one. I'm iterating over that material number list. And I'm going into this Get Details step where I am retrieving the group name. So if I expand these both out, you can see how I'm mapping into the material class as well as to the material definition. And if I make this full screen here to make it a bit more apparent, you can see how I've mapped, again, from that raw ERP output, including that material group name, over into my desired material format. And if I hop between these, you can see how it highlights for me very nicely which connection I'm working with. We're really trying to make this easy to use, so you don't have to require a sophisticated, skilled code writing engineer to do this. You can have someone who understands these things conceptually. So in this case, I am retrieving my materials and classes, and I'm able to, of course, go into a decision block. And this decision block allows me to specify a class name and say, hey, I really only want materials that are in this class. And then again, of course, if it fits that class, I save the MES object, and then I go on to the next material. And I loop over this over and over again until I run out of materials, and I am done, and I progress to my end block. So let's see that in action here on the screen. Here's my object editor, and again, if I clear these out, I get my materials, retrieve them all, and then I can call again that chart, loop over all of those, and get those classes. So you can see how really quickly, in just a few minutes, including with me talking over it, I'm able to really retrieve that data and use it in either an Ignition context, on a screen, on a table, maybe put it into a database table, or I'm able to retrieve them for use in my Sepasoft MES solution. We really hope we're showing here that we're enabling users, more users, to get into, understand those ERP to SCADA and MES communications, really democratizing that flow of data, not requiring so much expertise to make this possible.